Hey, people, what is up? Okay, so if I were to ask you the question, and this is going to see how well y'all know me out there, what brand pops into my head first when I think about an automatic knife? I'll give you a few guesses and go. Protech. Yeah, they're pretty good. One of my favorites, but no. Kershaw Launch. Yeah, that's a good series. Right up under Protech, in my opinion. Less money, good quality. I don't know exacto. Benchmade. Well, that's a hard no. Spyderco. Yeah, Spyderco makes a hell of an auto. They don't make enough of them, and they don't make an OTF, but they sure as shit should. I don't know exacto. Heretic, G&G Hawk. Whoa. Calm down on those last two. I got it exacto. Lightning. Bingo. I'm just fucking with y'all. Come on, y'all. Y'all know what it is. Exacto, stop fucking around. We read the title. We know what we came here for. Why do you always do this to us? Microtech. Yeah. Microtech is what always pops into my head when I think about excellent automatic knives. I don't know. They're just a go-to for me. They do perfection. And I don't always like everything they do, but I can appreciate everything they do. They're like Spyderco to me. So, this knife right here is the one we're going to talk about. Pretty obvious, right? This is a hell of a cool little knife, and it has a very specific thing that it does. Now, some of you already know what it does, some of you don't, but I'm going to review this knife not so much as a knife, but as a wallet. Exacto, the hell's wrong with you? It's a wallet. So, I'm going to show you how it works as a wallet. Maybe I'll do some in pants video. I don't know. I don't know if I clipped that in yet. Depends on how lazy I get. But I'm going to show you it as a wallet, how it works like that, and then I'm going to talk about the knife. I mean, if you really want to know how I feel about Microtechs, go to YouTube, search up there, and go Exacto, X4CTO, you know. Y'all know how to spell my name by now, right? And then put Microtech, and you'll find some videos I've done on Microtechs, and you'll kind of see how much I love Microtechs. I kind of went crazy there for a while. I've since calmed down on Microtechs, not on other brands, but either way, I still love them, and you can obviously tell that if you listen to me for any amount of time. So, as a wallet, a money clip, it's a nicer money clip than a lot of money clips. It can be a wallet. Now, I'm going to explain to you real quick how that works. So here's my wallet. This is one of my favorites, my little Perry Ellis. It's really thin. Okay. I like it. Slim, easy to go in the pocket, past my knives. I carry it front right pocket, behind all my knives, big, small, whatever, and it works well. Thin. This knife is thinner than it. So let's see how it looks with all the stuff in it. Okay, I had to stop the video, and we're going to try this again because I accidentally flashed my credit card number. Better than my dick, right? And almost every video, I get one or two thumbs down. I got a couple of haters out there that just really hate me, and I know one of them assholes would order a damn Benchmade on my credit card, so we're going to cut that out. I'm going to try this again. So my wallet. Thin wallet. We're going to take stuff out of it. Everything that's in there. Card, ID, couple cards here, and some cash. I'm going to take all that out. I'm going to put it in this knife, and I'm going to show you how it carries as a wallet. And we will try this shit again. Minus the information. Empty wallet. Look at that. So, you can get it all organized back there to the very back of the clip, and it holds quite a bit. Okay, look at that. Is that not a beautiful thing or what? Now, you can't actuate it while it's being a wallet, but it'll hold more. That's like, what, 4 or 5 cards? A couple of cardboard cards, like, you know, not business cards, but they're my medical cards. And I don't know, was that $400 or $500? So this right here is awesome. It's a minimalist wallet, and it's just as thin as that. It's a little heavier, but it's not much. This knife is not that heavy, but it's just as thin, and you got an extra knife on you. So I love the way Microtech did that. The pocket clip, the money clip, whatever you want to call it, I tend to think of it as a money clip because of how the springiness in the clip works. It's not as good a pocket clip as it is a money wallet clip, okay? So, I'll take all this out. We'll go back over the thing as a knife now. Un momento, por favor. Get all that out of here. All right. How is it as a knife? Well, let's start with the clip. You have that clip raised up quite a bit off the scale made for wallet duties, right? As such, you have a real springy clip, and it makes it great for the wallet thing, but not as good for the pocket thing. It depends on how thick your pockets are. If you wear like a little bit thinner materials like I do a lot, then this can kind of slide a little bit out of the pocket. It can kind of move a little bit. Now, my sister has one. She does the back pocket carry, so she carries it in her back pocket. It works pretty good for that. It's a thick clip, so the clip doesn't want to move around. It doesn't want to move too much in your pocket. It just kind of wants to slide out every now and then if your leg comes up and pushes it when you sit down, things like that. So the clip could be better for pocket carry, but is way, way good for wallet use. Just drop the whole thing in your pocket, right? So there's the clip. Of course, it is fastened with a couple of those crazy tri-head or triangle screws. Tri-wing, there you go. Tri-wing screws into the back, like a lot of Microtechs are, right? Little glass breaker duty here if you want. Maybe you could probably do something with that. It doesn't have a dedicated ball bearing in it like, you know, some of the other ones, but it could maybe do that. It has a little lanyard area. Okay, so that's that part. Your build is standard Microtech. You have a little bit of a sandwich action going on. You got the little X slide right here, you know, like they did on the newer Ultratechs and what have you. And it is stepped very well. It's concaved and stepped, and just the details on their buttons. Microtech does some of the best sliders. So the details are here, and we'll talk more about it in action, but it's good. Of course, you have this kind of frame system. The name of this knife, obviously, the Exocet. If you look at the little kit cars, the Exocet kit cars, it kind of resembles that. And I'm thinking that might have been where they got their inspiration. It has that structural integrity looking stuff going on. Do you need it on the scale? No, it's a design thing, but I think it's taken from the kit cars. You have your little cuts in it, your little, I guess, jimping. It's not real aggressive. It don't do a lot, but it does something. And you have that, like your standard Microtech. You have a little bit of a dip. If you can see that right there, you have a dip and a little bit of a flat. Well, you got a flat for the button, obviously, and you got the dips in the button. You got the dips over here, so it's really reminiscent of all your others, your Combat Troodons, your Microtechs. You can see where the lineage is in this, right? You know, typical OTF functionality inside if you take it apart, which of course you're going to need those tri-wing bits. If you take it apart, it's going to work just like all the other Microtechs. Now, action, fun part, right? Because of that button, and because of the smaller size and the spring setup, the way this is sprung, of course it fires hard, but just enough to get the blade out. That means the button is not hard to actuate like some of the older Microtechs. My wife can do this, my sister can do this, anybody that I've seen that doesn't usually have a lot of push in their thumb or pull to get these OTFs out, the Microtech ones especially, they can do this one. So it's a light, but it's very, if you've never fired a Microtech, you have to be very deliberate in what you're doing. It's not going to accidentally go off. It's not going to slide easy. I mean, even on a, where'd I put that? Even on a cheap OTF like this one, the way these work is they're not going to accidentally go off. I mean, you'd have a better chance at winning the lottery or getting me to like Benchmade. So good action, and it's just so smooth, so linear, and then you can feel it building, break. It's like a firearm trigger. It's awesome. Microtechs are like that. And it comes out good and with authority, quick and in a hurry, and retracts the same way. And it is very addictive. So it's typical Microtech action. If you know Microtech, I'm telling you nothing. This is for the people that don't know Microtech. And if you know Microtech, you either want one or you don't. You know, this is either for you or not. If you're the demographic for this, then you know what you like and you know which one you want. And there's so many different colors, so many different options. They got a Tonto blade shape. They got just so many things. The blade shape on this one, of course, double edge, dagger style, sharp on both edges. And when I say sharp, it's Microtech sharp. I will demonstrate that. A lot of times people don't like a dagger style because they're afraid they can't get enough edge, or it won't get thin enough at the edge to get a real good edge on. There was problems with thicker ones in the past. I mean, this is a thinner blade stock. It's hard to tell because of the double edge, but it is a thinner blade stock, but thick enough to be good and useful. In that it's not delicate, but it's also very fine edged. Of course, it's ground perfectly symmetrical. You have your black coating. Again, so many different variations, but this one, the one I like here, black coated on the bevels. And you got a satin and then a black coating inside of the little fuller and some holes cut out in it. If you can kind of see that. I don't know if I can show that real good with my lighting, but they're there. So all in all, typical Microtech. If you like Microtech, you'll like this one. Let me show you real quick. This is factory edge, okay? And you can see it has a smaller bevel. I don't even want to wager a guess at what it's ran at, but maybe in the 20s. But little wallet knife, right? Some people might think it's a novelty. It's not a novelty. This thing, oh my God, cuts like a dream, like any Spyderco I have. It's just so well sharpened. Okay, so that's one side. Flip it over. Let's get the other side. Oh yeah, same thing. So you got two whole knife edges of beautiful, beautiful cutting edge. And this thing, the way it cuts through paper, so good. I just sit here and play with this thing cutting. I just like the way it cuts. And, you know, being a stubby little blade, again, thinner blade stock, but being a stubby little blade, you might think, oh, it's not going to slice. Well, you'd be wrong. It does. And, you know, Microtech's known for their edges. They got good edges. So it's just a cool little idea, you know? You got your wallet, and you pull your wallet out, and you got your knife, and it's the same thing. I like that idea. If you were gonna get a money clip, or a money, a hard wallet, let's say, and you like knives, maybe you should give this one a look. If you're gonna get this just as a knife and you don't want to do the wallet thing, in the price range, these are about 250-ish, like say 250 to 300, depending on what you get, right? In the price range, I'd probably go Ultra Tech, straight up. If you're gonna spend 250 to 3, I'd go Ultra Tech all day for just a knife. But if you're going for the wallet functionality and you like this for that, this is one of the best, if not the best, wallet knife I've seen, right? I don't know. There might be some others out there, but I don't think they're as readily accessible and as affordable as this one. I know affordable is subjective, but I mean, if you had like $300 and you wanted to put in a nice money clip, but you want to buy the knife, I guess you won't have the $300 anymore. So you may have to just carry it as a knife until you get 300 more bucks, right? Oh man, it's a cool blade. It's a Microtech. Need I say more? Need I say that again? And man, I gotta watch it when I get Microtechs in my hand, because every time I do, it's like drugs. You know, you get that one hit and it's like, oh, here I go again. Here I go again, right off the wagon. Or on the wagon. What is it? It's on the wagon, right? Are you on the wagon? You're on the wagon getting whiskey off the wagon and drinking it, or you fell off the wagon because, like, the wagon was cool and you were sober on the wagon, but you fell off of it and fucked up. Well, I don't know, whatever. Digressing, maximum. Cool knife. If you're on the fence about it, then figure out what you want it for. And if you want it for the wallet, get it. Don't look back. If you want it for the knife, get the Ultra Tech. Or, just get you a Lightning. Nah, maybe not. Lightning's a cool knife. I'm not picking at it. I'm gonna get out of here. Oh, no, I'm not. Actually, PS, 204P steel, right? Analogous to M390 20CV. So the steel on this one, and a lot of the other variations. I believe all of them are all of them 204P. I don't know. There's so damn many. 204P. What do you want? $250. Cool knife. Cool design. Killer blade steel. Killer construction. Good pocket clip for what it's intended for. Mediocre for pocket carry. Again, it's a Microtech. Now I'm out of here. Life's short. Stay sharp. And don't spend all your damn money buying a wallet. Knife. Hey, people. We ain't done yet. Oh, shit, Exacto. Two hey peoples in one video? That's right. Double for your money. We have the McBee over there, because I'm going to show you how to carry that, how I do carry that. I have the Exocet. I'm going to show you that in pocket and kind of illustrate what I was talking about on the pocket clip. And you're going to get all the crotch action, because that's where we got to be. So if you look at the pocket clip here, big pocket clip, it's actually a little bit more obscene than the knife I'm carrying, which is pretty obscene. Okay, can you see that? There we go. 8010, bigger pocket clip. So, it is going to print a lot. If you look at the 8010 in pocket, carries pretty well. I like it. Pocket clip's wide, disperses the weight. It kind of keeps the knife from shifting. Likewise on the Exocet. However, since it is a money clip designed as such, it stays where you put it this way and this way, but this way and this way, it just kind of moves real easy. Okay, I don't know if I'm trying to look at the viewfinder through a camera or through a mirror. Like I said, professional grade A setup here. So it's not as tight, right? But it's not designed to be. But if you want to carry it like that in pocket, I'll show you a few other ways I would prefer to carry it if I was going to carry it as just a knife. So it comes out a little easy, goes in easy, but it comes out a little easy. Again, 80-10. So the way I carry, and I would like to carry this one as just a knife, would be up here. Like that, you see? And then I can get behind my 8010 and just bypass the Exocet. That's how I carry my McBee. The McBee got a strong pocket clip. It's little, it's tight. That's the way I like it. Little and tight. So right here is the way I carry my McBee. And I can just get past all of it. And then I'll have a wallet in there, right? So if you want to get to my wallet, you got to go past my hardware, which I'm going to fill it. And, you know, don't be playing around in my pocket. So that's how I would carry the McBee. That's how I do carry it. Or if I got a watch pocket, I'll do that. This may do a watch pocket pretty good. I'm not going to take my pants off on video and change to try out that. But I would like that. But it just, look at that. See how that just moves? And as I'm walking, as I'm doing stuff, you know, with my hips, it just kind of does its thing. And so I don't like that as much. Now, as a money clip, or as a wallet, right? You got your wallet action going on there, like I did, like I showed you, right? And you can just kind of drop it down in the pocket. Now, in these particular shorts, it bypasses the 8010. It just sits there, right there as a front pocket wallet. And, you know, don't print any more than something like this. I hope there's not a shadow on all this. Probably is. Probably screwing the whole video up. But there it is. That's how I would carry it. You can also carry, like my sister does, back pocket. Again, big clip, likely to get hung. And it can grab, because it's got that lip on it, right? So it can snag, and it's a big pocket clip, and it's real springy and not real thick. So you could also do like that, down in the waistband. Exacto, but it's gonna probably fire and like cut my dick off. Well, no. But then again, you know, what do I know? I don't know. May have happened. So yeah. Not so good for pocket carry. Hey, you want a size comparison? No. Oh, calm down. Talking about knives. See if we can get back here and do something. That's what I tell my wife sometimes. All right. Here's a dragonfly. All right. So it's a little bit smaller than a dragonfly. And funny thing I noticed since I got it on me, 8010. It's about the width. The width of the blade here is about the width of an 8010 at the tip. Similar tip profile, right? Not too far off. So, interesting little tidbits there. But yeah, it's about like a dragonfly. If you want to know the overall. A little bit longer on the dragonfly. But it's a good knife. So, again, carry it like a money clip, like a wallet. It's good. Carry it like a knife. You're going to have to figure out where you want to do that. So now I'm going to get out of here. I'm going to put all this hardware back in my pants. And I'll talk to y'all later. Life's short. Stay sharp.